This is the Aptera, the Sono Scion, and the Lightyear. All are solar electric vehicles set to hit the market over the next few years. While they have regular lithium-based batteries that can be charged using electricity from the grid, they can also use integrated solar panels to fully power shorter drives or supplement the vehicle's range for longer excursions.
Solar, only a few years ago, 2018, 2019, crossed the threshold where solar is now cheaper than basically anything else, certainly fossil fuels. The challenge is absolutely squeezing enough solar panels on the surface of your car so that it can drive without needing to be recharged.
For these vehicles, solar power can fuel between 15 to 45 miles of driving per day in sunny areas, and less when it's cloudy. This range is largely dependent on the car's design, which varies widely.
I mean, our vehicle looks more like a bird or a fish than it does almost anything else on the road today.
It's very practical. It's made for functionality.
Motors in the wheels and a large solar panel and extremely good aerodynamics.
While solar vehicles are finally on the verge of commercialization, the concept has been around for decades, largely popularized by competitions like the World Solar Challenge, an 1,800-plus mile race across Australia that's been happening since 1987.
In the beginning, nobody really knew whether it was possible to drive a car across the whole Australian continent on the silent power of nature, using no fossil fuel whatsoever, 3,000 kilometers. And in the early days, some of the teams took weeks to achieve their dream of doing it.
Now, though, the winning teams take about 4 days to complete the race. The fastest cars are single-seaters and don't look like anything you'd see on the road today. But as interest in solar car commercialization has picked up over the past decade, now there's a whole segment of the competition devoted to multi-passenger vehicles.
2013 was our first event where we launched the Cruiser class, seeing where this could go as a practical car. And in fact, the Dutch launched their company Lightyear, based on their original cruiser class car.
Lightyear, as well as German company Sono, will hit the European market first, while Southern California-based Aptera will be released in the US, where Kamen says the appeal is broad.
The idea of a truly autonomous vehicle kind of goes back to the whole muscle car, the Hell's Angels, the idea that, you know, you are truly independent of infrastructure, and that's ultimately what a solar car gets you towards.
But because top-of-the-line solar panels are only about 22% efficient, and the small surface area of these cars limits how many panels they can have, solar power alone won't support long-distance drives anytime soon. But even if you can only get a dozen or so solar-powered miles per day, Hans still thinks it's worth it.
It is very cost-effective. It doesn't add a lot of costs onto the bill of material. So there's actually no reason why not to integrate it.
Investors might be wary of solar in general, though, as many solar panel companies went bankrupt or underperformed expectations in the early 2010s. The only public company of the three, Sono Motors, saw its stock plummet after last year's listing.
Wasn't the problem on Wall Street, when you say solar, it's almost a bad word, because so many investors have gotten burned on so many of these solar plays.
Ive says some investors don't understand that solar is only one component of this tech, and that these cars can also use grid electricity. Once they get it, Ives thinks they'll come around.
The story is starting to resonate with investors despite a risk-off market.
One of the first cars to hit the market will be the Sono Scion, which is scheduled to begin production in Europe in mid-2023. The company says it already has 42,000 reservations for the vehicle, which is priced starting at $25,000.
We get it so affordable because we do five things different. First, we don't produce on our own. Contract manufacturing with Valmet Automotive in Finland. Second is we have just one variant. This car comes in any color you like, as long as it's black. Third is we do online direct sales. Fourth is we have no steel stamping. It's an aluminum space frame, very safe car. And fifth is it has no paint, because it has solar panels on the outside.
The company plans to sell the Scion in the US eventually, where Han says it would make an ideal second vehicle for short distance commuters. The car's lithium iron phosphate battery gets 190 miles per charge before the added power from the solar panels, which cover the roof, the hood, and the sides.
So this car gives you per year 5,700 miles free of charge because it comes from the sun. This is roughly 15 miles a day.
The car may not look as futuristic as some might imagine a solar electric vehicle would, but Ives admires the company's overall practical approach.
You know, a lot of these early business models in disruptive electric vehicle, they go for the Super Bowl. Build the factory, big business model, raise significant amount of capital. You know, Sono's kind of gone the opposite path. First build it, then get more capital.
In terms of looks, Aptera Motors is on the opposite end of the spectrum as Sono. This company's zippy three-wheeler definitely turns heads on the highway.
You know, a lot of the modern EVs, especially the SUVs and stuff, there's some that are creeping over 8,000 pounds. Some notable monsters at almost 10,000 pounds. So, you know, a lot of the big SUV EVs, the battery packs in those EVs actually weigh more than the Aptera altogether.
Wow. Aptera's base model has a lithium-ion battery with a 250-mile range, and its most premium model has a 1,000-mile range. That's possible because the vehicle is so lightweight. On an average Southern California day, CEO Chris Anthony says you'll get an additional 30 solar-powered miles per day, and 11,000 each year. Overall, the two-seater is designed to maximize efficiency.
You only get 25 to 27% of the energy out of the fuel you burn in a combustion engine. So we move to electric and actually have our motors in the wheels, which is even more efficient and powerful for our driving.
Depending on range and other optional features, the Aptera costs between $26,000 and $48,000. However, Anthony says that due to supply chain issues, prices are expected to increase. The company says there are 37,000 pre-orders for the vehicle, which is technically classified as a motorcycle, though you don't need to have a motorcycle license or wear a helmet to drive it. The vehicle's body will be manufactured by the CPC Group in Italy and assembled here in Aptera's headquarters, starting next year.
Our amazing facility here in Carlsbad, California is really broken up into two sections. One is our base assembly line, which is the blue line that runs around the factory. And in the center is our battery line, the green lines that run around the factory. Over an 8-hour shift, we can build about 40 vehicles a day. Two shifts, we can build about 80 vehicles a day, so 20,000 vehicles a year.
And then there's Lightyear, the Dutch company born out of the World Solar Challenge. A limited number of its first model, the Lightyear Zero, will hit the roads in Europe next month, with a mass market vehicle expected in Europe, the US, and other global markets in 2025. Like Aptera, Lightyear also designed its car with aerodynamic efficiency in mind, placing their motors in the wheels too.
So only really when you go back to a blank sheet of paper, revisit the whole structure of the car and the technology, that's where you can actually get to those being very close, the energy consumption every day and energy yield.
Oof Sloat says Lightyear is targeting customers that would not normally have considered an EV.
A lot of the reason why people are not switching to EVs are charging and range. They're not at the same level as a combustion car. And what we're doing is we're going to a level where actually you have to recharge less than you would have to refuel when you had the combustion car.
Lightyear's lithium-ion battery gets 390 miles per charge, with an additional 20 or so miles of solar power in a climate like California. Like Sono, Lightyear is also partnering with Finnish company Valmet Automotive to manufacture its vehicles. While the first limited edition Lightyear cars will cost about $250,000, Oof Sloat says that once production scales, the Lightyear 2 will come in around $30,000.
Solar panels are so inexpensive, and integrating them into the skins is so easy, that once you get over that initial learning curve, it's hard for me to envision that this won't be cost effective.
It may be a while, though, before we start seeing other automakers incorporating solar into their electric vehicles.
On the average EV, you would only get maybe 10, 12 miles a day of solar charge range. So then you're in a question of, you know, does it justify the cost to add the solar equipment? I think that if certain niche players become more efficient over time, solar could really make sense to them.
Cameron sees solar cars gaining traction in sunny areas where EV charging infrastructure is sparse.
In the Southwest, in equatorial areas, where the charging infrastructure might be coming slowly. Morocco, Kenya, Mexico.
And while Cameron has put down a deposit for an Aptera, he says he's most excited about the tech that's to come.
Now if we can next get into solar cars where the windows are also collecting solar, now we're starting to get to a vehicle that on a good sunny day could recharge itself so it could go up to say 80 or 100 miles.
Very little people drive 100 miles per day, right? So that means that for most of us, the car would just always be charged.
It really builds into this idea that as we electrify transportation, we're not actually going to be stressing the grid more. Vehicles themselves can be more and more autonomous. And in the end, I think we're going to be selling electricity out of our solar cars back into the grid.